Hello and welcome to Wisdom Trek. This is Guthrie Chamberlain and I'm your guide to wisdom and creating a living legacy. Thank you for joining us for this 7 day a week, 7 minutes of wisdom podcast. This is day 184 of our trek, and yesterday we hiked the should have, would have, and could have trail, or could be referred to as the tyranny of the should. For today, we will stop by 12 mile markers for building characters, which will result in 6 character traits that you will possess as a result. If you miss any of our Days of Wisdom Trek episodes, please go to wisdom-trek.com to listen to them and to read our daily journal. We are recording our podcast from the studio at the Big House at Marriott, Ohio. It is starting out a busy week as expected, but we are accomplishing a significant amount and also completing some plans for 2016. We moved our large wind chimes over the weekend to the back corner of the Big House so that we can enjoy them while working at our second floor office. It is a large wind chime and the sounds are very melodious. We are also enjoying the return of a red-tailed hawk today. It did appear to be looking for some food, so the mice and the chipmunks would do well to stay hidden today. But let's shift now and look at our trek for today. When we are going on a difficult hike, one of the resulting benefits will be to help to build a persistent resolve to continue on, even when you may not feel like it. This in turn helps you to build a strong character. And it is now time to set out on our trek, as we will search for the 12-mile markers that will help us to build a good character. And then we will explore the resulting 6 character traits that we should all obtain. So the title for today is the 12 mile markers for building your character. And we will be looking at these 12 mile markers in the first person. So number 1 is, I possess the right motivation. I realize that in some capacity, everyone is a leader. As a leader, I am called to be an example setter of high character to the people to whom I am responsible. Whether they are my peers, children, employees, or other constituents. No matter if it seems inefficient, inconvenient, or ineffective, I will build character because it is the right thing to do. The second mile marker is, I possess an accurate mindset. My character flaws undermine my leadership, but they are correctable. Character is who I am. Competency is what I do. I will no longer confuse the two. Character is not only attractive to me, but is irresistible. The third point is, I possess the freedom to choose. I am 100% in control of my character and my responses to others. I choose to be a leader of character. I regret that in my past, my character has made some poor choices. I will do all in my power to change. I will become more like my mentors and models that I most desire. Number 4, I possess a teachable spirit. I am designed to be a lifelong learner. I am teachable. I have a strong bias to apply what I learn to who I am and what I do. Number 5, I possess an optimistic vision. A few might remember my competence, but virtually all will remember my legacy of character, whether it's good or bad. Many will exceed me in my various competencies, but I will set my sight on building a reputation of uncommon character. Number 6, I possess a clear target. I know the bullseye of high character. I know exactly what character ethics are and the corresponding behaviors I desire, even though I may struggle to achieve them consistently. Number 7, I possess the right tools. I have taken the time to assess and acquire the correct resources to support my character building journey, including a list of defined character ethics and a support system of like-minded leaders. Number 8, I possess a sensitive conscience. I may not always act on every conviction, but I have a conscience that will consistently generate a sense of great personal peace when I act in high character and appropriate guilt when I do not. Mile marker number 9, I possess ability to find a caring mentor. My mentors know me personally, and we have agreed on transparent, accountable, encouraging relationships as it relates to building character. My mentors help me to create and maintain conditions and principles necessary to build my character. Our respective roles and expectations are defined and mutually understood. Number 10, I possess an integrating perspective. My goal is to operate out of one unifying and aligning character identity. I will tirelessly work and reconcile all my various relationships to conform to my single identity. Mile marker 11, I possess a high view of relationships. I value relationships, but I am not perfect. I want to forgive those who make errors and be forgiven as well when I commit them. While this does not eliminate the consequences of committing wrong or omitting rights, it assures others that I earnestly value them. And mile marker number 12, I have counted the cost. If I start, there's no going back. I will be painfully exposed for what I am if I attempt to champion a double standard or refuse to confront chronically poor character of those in my charge or completely abandon my pursuit of character. And now that we have a firm grasp of these 12 measures of building a character, let us now explore the 6 character traits that make up a strong ethical character. The best roads to a better life is to be a better person, and all of us can be better. I like to refer to these as the 6 BCs of character, which are conscience, courage, consideration, compassion, confidence, and control. Let's look at each one of these traits. Number 1, be a person of conscience. Listen to the inner voice that helps you to know right from wrong and urges you to do what is good and noble. Number 2, be courageous. Confront the challenges and choices of your life forthrightly. Make the tough decisions that need to be made, and above all, maintain your integrity by doing what you know to be right, even when it costs you more than you want to pay. Number 3, be considerate. Be more deliberative, thoughtful, and attentive to know how your words and actions will affect others and reflect on your character. Think ahead so that you can avoid undesirable and undesired consequences. Number 4, be compassionate. Demonstrate a genuine concern for the well-being of others. Be kinder and more charitable. Strive to understand more and judge less. Number 5, be confident in your capacity to overcome whatever difficulties come in your way with integrity and dignity. Don't underestimate your resiliency. Resolve to persist until you prevail. And number 6, be in control of your emotions, appetites, and urges that tempt you to compromise your principles or sacrifice long-term goals for short-term indulgences. Remember, your character is your destiny. Your integrity will lead you onto the correct trails of life. Proverbs 10:9 puts it this way, "People with integrity walk safely, but those who follow crooked paths will be exposed." And also in Proverbs 20, verse 7, "The godly walk with integrity. Blessed are their children who follow them." So today on our trek, we learn from the 12 mile markers along the trail that helps us to build characters and the results of the 6 character traits of a person with good character and integrity. So I want to ask you this question. Does your life reflect what we have learned? And as you have opportunity, continue to hike on this trail to strengthen your character. Allow your character to be an example to your family and friends as you encourage them to join us each day and then come along with us for another day of Wisdom Trek, Creating a Legacy. And we will explore the concept that you must give to others in order to reach your successful destination. That will finish our podcast for today. Remember to listen to your daily dose of wisdom each day at wisdom-trek.com. And please share Wisdom Trek with your family and friends through email, Facebook, Twitter, or in person as you meet with them and invite them to come along with us each day. If you would like to be added to our weekly email updates or special publications from Wisdom Trek, just text the word WISDOM to 44222 on your phone and you will receive a message asking you for your email address. It's very quick and easy to do, and we promise to make our emails very limited. The journal for today's trek can be found at wisdom-trek.com. Thank you so much for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor, but most importantly, your friend, as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek podcast and journal each day. As we take this trek together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. This is Guthrie Chamberlain reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and then create a great day every day. See you tomorrow.